In this video, we will discuss variational methods, in particular the Ritz method, for approaching the ground state energy of a system. If we look at a quantum mechanical system with Hamiltonian H, we always want to know what's the ground state energy, because that's the energy that the system will probably have in nature. However, the exact solution, which is solving the eigenvalue equation of H, is difficult and often impossible to do analytically. Therefore, approximate methods are a very useful way to do these calculations. One example of an approximate method is perturbation theory. If we can separate the Hamiltonian into a part where we know the exact solutions, H0, and a small perturbation, we can get good results using perturbation theory. H0 could be something like the harmonic oscillator or the hydrogen atom. However, if we cannot separate the Hamiltonian like this, perturbation theory won't help us. Instead, we can use a variational method. In variational methods, you start with a test wave function, psi t, and slightly change it until you reach the smallest energy that you can find. In fact, we can show that the following energy functional is always greater than or equal to the ground state energy E0 for all test wave functions. So psi t can help us find an upper bound to E0. We will prove this statement at the end of the video. A convenient way to approach the ground state energy is now to add some parameters in the test wave function, for instance like this, where A, B, C, and D have to be determined. By using this test wave function, the energy functional will also depend on A, B, C, and D. This means we can take the derivative of E with respect to the parameters and set it 0, thus finding an extremal point. In other words, we want to find those values for A, B, C, and D such that the resulting energy is as low as possible. This is known as the Ritz method, named after the Swiss physicist Walter Ritz. To conclude this video, let us prove that the energy functional really always is greater than or equal to the ground state energy E0. To do so, let us assume that the exact solutions to the Hamiltonian are given by psi n with energies En. However, we don't know what they are. We start by inserting a completeness relation right next to the Hamiltonian. This is possible since the psi n constitute a complete basis. We can then let the Hamiltonian act on the wave function psi n, which yields En psi n. Next, we write out the sum over n starting from 0. In the second term, E1 is greater than E0, so we know that the second term must be greater than E0 times the two products of wave functions. And also in the third term, E2 is also greater than E0, and so on. In summary, the whole sum must be greater than or equal to the same expression, but with En replaced by E0, such that we can write it outside the summation symbol. Why did we put a greater or equal sign here? In the special case that the test wave function is exactly equal to psi 0, then this is an equality. In all other cases, it's an inequality. We can now remove the ket bra psi n terms, since they are complete bases, and end up with E0, the ground state energy, which completes the proof. And that's pretty much it for this video. Thanks for watching.